Point, I assume the hat will now be removed. Paul Thomas, the referee, said the most charismatic fighter he's ever been in with was Nigel Benn. The best fighter, Ronald Winky Wright. I wonder if there might come a time when Amir Khan is a man who would rival both those terrific fighters. Here goes Amir Khan with professional appearance number 10 against Rachid Drilzane. He said he's going to pace himself, conserve energy. But he says there's so much more that we've yet to see. What he's produced in the gym, in practice, in sparring with Suleiman Enbay, the talented WBA light welterweight champion, the Frenchman. Oh, good shot. Good uppercut, first scoring punch. Drilzane with plenty of support in the auditorium. His fans are making themselves heard.
This could shape up to be quite interesting, John, because this kid isn't overawed, and Khan will need to keep a nice tight defence. It's another import for him, so, you know, and obviously they're up to the next weight division now, so he's just got to be a little bit more cautious. The left hand up, Drilzane, has quite a big frame.
He is sturdy looking individual. He's been fighting at light welterweight. Amir Khan, a lightweight, really, remember, and he said that even when he's outside the ring, he only walks around about 10 stone 3, the light welterweight limit 10 stone. So it's not as though he has to boil down at all there. Good reactions from Khan as he just ducked away from that attempted chopping right hand. Oh dear, chopping right hand from Drilzane. One or two fighters tonight who've been struggling with the feet on this ring surface. Khan making a more measured start than he has of some of his previous contests. Just taking a little look at Drilzane. Keeping his glove up as Drilzane trying to rough him up. That's a good shot from Khan, good solid right hand. Jabbing well, Duke.
Yeah, he's got nice reflexes as Khan. He pops a jab really well. It's nice to see that he is learning his trade. He stopped jumping around as much now, looks to assert himself from a flat base, a flat-footed base.
Oliver Harrison, Khan's trainer, said Drilzane is strong but a little bit static. He said it's all very well being strong, but let's see how his speed is, how he copes with speed. And good hooks into the body. Body shots from Khan, looking to get the high-held guard of the Frenchman dragged down a little. Oh, that's another really good left hand from Khan. Good hand speed in the closing seconds of an opening round, which is bossed the further it's gone. Good round for Khan. Well, it's interesting there as Khan gets instructions in his corner that in the opposite side, Rachid Drilzane chose not to sit down at any stage. The old George Foreman trick. Fighters look across to the other side and see the man there is at corner men, very slow getting out and making a little bit of a statement. I don't need to sit down.
Yeah, he's just trying to show to Khan, obviously, that he's not tired, John. He doesn't need to rest. Drilzane's got a nice tight guard himself. He doesn't look too afraid of Khan, not afraid to put pressure on him.
Just caught Khan with a right hand there as he came in. That's good work from Khan, though, putting his punches together well. A smile on the lips of Rachid Drilzane. First time he's ever fought outside his homeland, and that's a nice, sweet little left-hand counter from Khan. So I'm getting carried away with the idea that this is a genuine world title belt or anything. It's a belt for young contenders, the intercontinental light welterweight belt. But it's the first genuine, tangible reward in terms of a belt that Khan will have had since his amateur days. At home, he's got cabinet fulls of medals and belts from his terrific amateur career, which culminated in that Olympic silver medal in Athens.
Khan can't take it for granted that he won't be hit with the overhand right, John, when he keeps his left low, like what this kid's just done now. He's just cottoned on to the fact that he's carrying it really low, and he can pot shot with the right hand.
Drilzane fancies that shot there again, the right hand, right on cue, well read by Duke McKenzie, world champion himself, of course, in years gone by, and a couple of solid-looking right hands from Drilzane, showing that Khan's defence is maybe not quite as impervious as it might be. That's good work from Khan. First time that he's fought beyond six rounds, Khan, if it goes as far as that. Perhaps his hardest fight so far, the Hungarian, Laszlo Kalmyati, over in Belfast earlier this year.
Khan's speed at the moment is the difference between these two, John. He's just beaten Drilzane to the punch.
He's taking a careful look at it, though. There's no going in there and throwing the kitchen sink at Drilzane and none of the leaping around. Tidy it up, you hear the referee, Paul Thomas, say. That's a terrific shot. Doubled up beautifully on the left hand there, Khan.
Just feel Khan moving to the task now, John. He's standing his ground and really trying to slip these shots in. They look quite impressive. He's a much classier boxer when he sets himself and stops jumping around the ring, which is what he's doing now. He's walking around the ring, conserving energy.
Well, he's had to take a couple of shots in this second round, but that's what he'd hoped for. Drilzane still standing in his corner, but there you see how Khan was really putting his punches together well.
Nice little 1-2 combination there, John.
Into the third, it's a 10-round fight, remember. Drilzane getting animated instructions from his corner. I think they are encouraged with the way in which their man has been able to get through with that right hand. Oh, Khan's gone down there, but that's a slip again, says referee Paul Thomas, and rightly.
Well, Drilzane was just putting the pressure on in there, John, and he just lost his footing.
Khan now looking to plant his feet and throw punches with more intent. Good shot, and another one. That's a really classy left hand.
It's a sweeping long left hook he's leaning in with, John, and he's catching this kid beautifully.
Oh, that is class. And Drilzane now has to take backward steps. Amir Khan is really starting to unload here in the third round. The head's dangerously close to clashing.
Drilzane can't deal with the speed, John. Right now, he can't find a way to get in close to Khan.
Look at that. Really good quality left-hand lead.
Khan needs to shorten those punches on the inside. He's swinging the right hand over, needs to shorten it in.
It's all a learning curve for Amir Khan. Nobody's saying this man is a Ricky Hatton or a Diego Corrales, but he's a step up in class. He's a move forward, and all the time, as he moves through his professional career, Khan is on the learning curve.
Khan growing in confidence, John, round by round. He's not loading up on all these punches, which is another bit that he's learnt in his education.
Drilzane, remember, has won his last five fights. Good solid right hand from the Frenchman from Marseille. And again, the head's going dangerously close. Good left hand, terrific left hook from Khan. Drilzane takes it well, though, and shakes his head as much as to say, you're going to have to find a little bit more than that.
Drilzane just switched on the inside, switched to the southpaw stance, came back with a straight left and caught Khan with the shot, but Khan returning kind.
Khan going through the gears now. Just waiting for an opportunity to land maybe a counter shot. That's a good lead from Drilzane, only a glancing blow though. Khan just choosing to pick his punches, bide his time. Another good flashing left hand in the closing stages of this round. Another round for Khan. Khan really started to put his punches together in the closing stages of that round, and that was a solid left hook there.
It was a nice combination, John, nice two-fisted attack from Khan. I've got Khan winning everything at the moment, John. He's boxing quite an intelligent fight.
Khan's got Jamie Moore among the people in his corner, good left-hand lead. Moore, who had that thrilling victory over Matthew Macklin a few weeks ago. Not a very popular figure up in the northwest.
Drilzane just starting to mark up now, John, around his left eye.
Well, no shock there, because it's pot-shotting for Amir with that left-hand lead. Khan is ever more or less unmarked. Oh, good body shot from Khan, switching the attack beautifully. There was a Frenchman called Mounir Guebas earlier this year who came over and stopped another lightweight contender, Danny Hunt, in three rounds back in May. I think that one was at the York Hall. But no sign at the moment that Drilzane is going to repeat that sort of shock result. And he seems to have lost the confidence to throw that right hand, which he was having some success with in the second round.
Well, Khan's winning these rounds, John, because he's just beating his kid to the punch. Plain and simple. He's beating him to the jab and the right hands. His lateral movement is superior to Drilzane. Drilzane's not fighting at a hard enough pace to bother Khan.
Khan just content to work away behind that very, very fast left-hand lead. And there you see, as he goes into defensive mode, Drilzane just left punching fresh air.
When Khan puts his combinations together, he stops Drilzane in his tracks.
Quiet around this from Khan, but I don't doubt that he'll try and put his foot on the accelerator in this last minute.
I think it's a more measured approach by Khan, John. He would almost appear to be pacing himself.
Well, he'd only had 23 rounds, you know, under his belt in his entire professional career. He needs rounds. He needs competitive action. It's not just about going in there and blowing people away. There's a better right hand from Drilzane. And covering up well as Khan tried to counter with that combination. Slightly slappy look about the right hand there from Khan as he went in over the top. Another round for Khan, but not perhaps quite the fireworks that some expect.
Downstairs, sink it in with your hands up.
And they are saying to Amir Khan that he has got to work away towards the body. But as he does so, be careful. They don't want him to get clipped by those rogue right hands. Good learning fight this for Khan. Drilzane still with a bit of ambition, Duke. That's a good body shot from Khan. That's what the corner are looking for him to do, and another one. They said go downstairs, and two really good meaty right hands, but he's just clipped by a left-hand counter.
Yeah, he was. But what he did in return, John, was stopped a beautiful little left hook on the inside, a reaction shot from Khan.
The horns of the French fans you can perhaps hear on our effects mics at ringside. A bit of a Gallic flavour to the atmosphere here. He's doing okay, is Rachid Drilzane. He's making a fight of it. He's got a good chin, Duke.
Yeah, we didn't want to see him just fall over, John, in the first round, but, you know, this kid's come to win, he's come to fight, obviously. Tactics just a little bit wrong at the moment because he's allowing Khan much too much free range.
Khan trying to beckon him in, wants to have the opportunity to fire in fast counters.
This is where Khan likes it, John, nice and long. Long arm shots.
Oh, he got clipped by a right hand, though. Right hand counter from Drilzane as Khan started to unload.
He's pulling out with his chin up in the air, John.
Khan?
Yeah, Khan's pulling out with his chin up in the air. He's got a nice attack and he pulls out with his chin up in the air. So, you know, Drilzane can throw these sweepy shots and he might get lucky.
Drilzane, incidentally, has never had a stoppage victory in his 13 professional fights. He's that strong boy, but not a noted puncher.
So Khan's got a very useful jab. It's a hurtful jab, but he uses it correctly. Got a beautiful sweeping left hook, which I think is his best shot, John.
You look at the possible tests ahead for Khan after this, as the WBU lightweight champion, Graham Earle, there's the new British lightweight champion, Jonathan Thaxton. I'm sure that both of them are going to be watching this with great interest and seeing the way that Drilzane is managing to get through.
Nice attack from Khan.
Well, there we go, Khan finishing the round strongly, and I think that that is enough to get him another round under his belt, Duke. He's got 5 out of 5 on my card, would you agree?
Mine as well, John, yeah.
See what they're saying in that corner, Oliver Harrison, a little bit quietly spoken, but maybe we can just about make it out.
He's tired too. Can you hear me?
Some of the replay of the action from that fifth round. Drilzane had his moments, but Khan with the hand speed. Not really a clear power shot, that, but that's a good body shot.
Yeah, that was a nice sweeping
There's
shot.
There's payback time, though.
Nice sweeping sort of right uppercut to the body from Khan, but Drilzane took it pretty well.
That's really good. Four or five punches, all of them scoring shots.
Seconds out, round six.
Oliver Harrison a little bit slow getting out, smearing some grease around the left cheek of Khan. Maybe that right hand has caused a little bit of bruising. It certainly landed pretty flush.
Well, if Drilzane wants to win this fight, John, it's time for a change of tactics. He needs to get to Khan, obviously, a lot quicker, close him down and try what Khan's doing, try to work his body. Because Khan's using all of this ring pretty well. This is what he likes to do, keep it nice and long, nice and at range, where he can start working the combinations.
He's padded from Khan, good jab.
That's a hurtful jab, John. It's a hurtful jab, it's a stinging jab. When you land with that, the confidence just comes. The rest of the combinations just want to start to work.
Well, the critics, and there are plenty of them, have wanted to see Khan go through the paces and be in with a man who genuinely has ambition to and ability, I might say, to really mix it with him. And Drilzane has not done a bad job. Khan now, though, I'm sure, will be looking to start to put the power shots together. It's a good shot from Drilzane again. Khan smiles back at him, but he had to take it.
Just a right-hand lead, straight shot from Drilzane. Couldn't miss Khan as he paused with the jab. Khan won't look to... He won't get mad, John, he'll get even.
Almost on the target with that right-hand counter. Khan, who works away in the gym in Salford, caught by a left hand there as he came in trying to throw those body shots. It was a good left hand counter from Drilzane. And Khan has taken as many shots in this fight as he has, I think, perhaps in his entire career. Good right hand again. Over the top. He's open to that one. when it goes back to the drawing board and to analyse this one, the openness to that right hand is something that's going to be analysed long and hard, I'm sure.
But it's a mistake that he's made probably throughout his whole career, John. He doesn't make many, but sometimes he does get lazy with the jab, and that's what he gets in return.
No cliche though, you expect to get your toes wet if you step into the pond, and this is the hurt game, and Khan cannot have everything all his own way. Referee Paul Thomas having a word with Drilzane for holding and pulling down. Closing seconds of the sixth round. Another round to Khan, but he has been clipped. Khan had to take a couple of shots in that round, and Drilzane has still got winning intent.
Well, John, you know, he's gritty, that's what he's known for. He hasn't come to lie down, he doesn't get knocked out so often, so...
Khan moving into uncharted territory, into the seventh round. He's never been as far as this before. First time in a 10-rounder.
Oh, that's good to see, John. It's good to see him into the seventh round. And it's also good to see now that he's carrying the left hand a lot higher.
I'm sure they'll have said that to him. Some wise heads in that corner. Oliver Harrison, Jamie Moore, Dean Powell. Sure, they'll all have said, don't do anything stupid. And here comes Drilzane, fancying it. Two good right hands, and he's going looking for Khan. Khan suddenly has to use his mobility and his defensive skills to stay away from the Frenchman.
Yeah, and then mixed with three crisp jabs, John. That's pretty sensible. Not getting carried away. As I said, he made the kid miss and then made him pay. Mustn't get overconfident. Got to keep him.
That's a left hand. Did he touch down? He's given it as a knockdown. And Paul Thomas, I think, absolutely rightly, has given that as a knockdown. Now, Khan hates it. The crowd hates it. But I reckon that there was a glove which did touch down. And in that case, that is a legitimate knockdown. Khan did not like that one. But we'll have to see that one perhaps in a replay at the end of the round. Because it looked to me as though he did touch down, Duke.
Well, he touched down, John, there's no doubt about it. If you touch the canvas, the referees themselves give you a standing 8 count.
Well, a little bit of drama in the seventh round. Khan not hurt, but down. So, in theory, he would be heading towards losing this round 10-8.
Well, there's a question mark for you now, John. It wasn't a big shot. We'll have to wait until we see it on the replay to discover whether or not it was a clean blow or he lost his footing.
Well, it was a left hand, wasn't it? He's swinging him around with a left hand.
That'll give Drilzane all the confidence he needs. It's up to Khan now to answer the critics.
Well, Drilzane clearly fancies the case now. He wants to create his own little bit of history, and his fans on the far side are going wild. Good left hand from Drilzane, and a terrific response from Khan. Really good exchange there. Both of them landed more or less flush. Khan, though, showing himself too easy to hit. Taken too many shots, I'm sure, for his backers' liking.
There's the right hand again, John. You called it as I said it.
Well, it's the closing stages of the seventh round now of 10. Khan's winning the fight, but knocked down there in that round. And, well, is that a 10-8 round against him? I think Paul Thomas was right. Let's take another look at it. This is from the wide shot. Now, there's the left hand. Yeah, he's touched down. That's a knockdown, Duke. No question.
Yeah. Watch it again, John, on the replay.
Is his foot caught in the rope? He's just off balance. I mean, okay, he's not hurt, but that's a knockdown.
Yeah, it was a knockdown, not a legitimate knockdown. The shot didn't land cleanly, not enough to leave him concussed, but he touched down nonetheless.
Came back well, though.
keep doing
came back
doing.
Well.
And whether that's done, head low, head up. Head low, don't keep up too
the,
long.
The scorecard is Duke seeing it at the moment, and there you are. The knockdown makes it a 10-8 round to Drilzane.
Is
that the first round that he's lost in his professional career? He had a dodgy one against Comiati, but I think when he hung his chin out and got clipped, but certainly that's the first time he's been floored. Into the eighth round. On our card, on Duke's card, Amir Khan 4 points ahead, but Drilzane still dangerous. Well, the crowd a little bit subdued.
Yeah, he's winning his fight at the canter, John, he really is. Just doesn't need to do anything silly. I mean, what he's done in that round was just was a little bit silly, a little bit complacent, which would give this guy all the confidence that he needs, this Drilzane. But Khan's just got to keep using the jab, keep feeding the jab, keep the left hand up, not allow him to get any confidence, make him miss, make him pay. It's as simple as that. Beautiful body shot.
But he's been clipped too much, for my way of looking at it, against a man who does not have huge credentials. He's beating him to the jab as well now on occasion, as well as with that right hand. The right hand's been a thorn in the side of Amir Khan. But Drilzane has showed himself to be more than a lot of people expected. That's good. Good 1-2 from Khan, but he stood back and admired his work.
Well, he's a little bit more weary now, John. Obviously, he's felt the power of this kid and he's just more weary.
There's the right hand again from Drilzane. Khan coming back with a flurry of pitter-pat punches, but the right hand is a danger.
Tape's just coming loose on Khan's glove. Referee need to get a hold of that.
Good uppercut from Khan. It's a good job that Drilzane doesn't have the punching power of an Asselino Freitas or somebody of that ilk.
Oh, and a left hook. And a right hand he walks onto again there.
Freitas, the dynamite punching Brazilian, for those who haven't seen him. Applause from ringside for that fast combination from Khan.
Well, Khan's got his boxing brain back on now. Put the hands up and the chin tucked down. Not going to take any chances. He's too well schooled for that, John.
Well, he's had to think, and there's nothing, you know, there's no bad thing about that. There's a clash of heads in there. Khan got caught pretty flush by the forehead of the Frenchman. But these fast bowl-over knockouts don't really do too much good. I remember a few years ago in the learning curve of Amir Khan when he went in against Bel Castro, the Italian, and two fights like that. He learnt more from those than all the quick knockouts. Nazim Hamed, that is.
Yeah, these fights, John, they hold you in good stead when you step up in class, real genuine class. As you've already stated, the domestic scene's red hot. So, you know, let's just hope he goes that way. You know, I mean, he's learning his trade, and that's what it's all about.
He's rode out the storm and he's won that round and won it handily. So after the 10-8 round, which was the seventh, back to business. Hear what's going on in the corner.
Washed out, Oliver.
Yeah. Here's some more action. That's a really good right hand, that one from Amir Khan. Really good shot. Drilzane catches him with the left hand, but the bulk of the work there was coming from Khan.
You've got to move your top off when you walk
Dean
away.
Dean Powell there saying, move yourself, okay? Get some lateral movement.
Dean knows his stuff, John. He worked with me in many of my fights.
Speak down there, just
keep
moving.
He's behind, he's taking and the ball. And there's Drilzane. Tu descends, tu parles, tu piques là. Okay,
pretty much unmarked. And the big, big crowd here, something between 7,000 and 8,000, they reckon, was going to be here. On the banks of the Thames at the XL. And most have stayed on after those hugely dramatic fights earlier on and that brilliant victory for Audley Harrison. Good right hand from Drilzane again.
So I like Khan when he's got his hands up, John. For me, he just looks so much more complete when he's got that left hand in place, because then he can really work the jab. But when he drops it down to his waist, he can be hit with the right hand, he's wide open to it.
And there'll be fighters who come along who've got much more of a dig than this fella.
Absolutely, there are plenty of bangers in this weight division, John. I just wonder if Khan's starting to feel the pace a little bit now, John.
Well, it'd be no surprise if he were. I mean, he's 20 years old, still growing, still maturing, still learning. He's fought 10 rounds in sparring before, but it's an altogether different thing in front of a big, big crowd. Good shot. Really good right uppercut. Drilzane takes it well. That's as good a shot as Khan has thrown for some time.
Yeah, it's more psychological than obviously physical, John, when you get in there and it's your first 10-round fight.
Is he now going to have to go the distance? How much is he learning from this one? All questions which we'll analyse, of course, in the minutes to come, and we'll be reading about it, no doubt, in your papers tomorrow and on Monday. We'll hear from Barry McGuigan at the end of this round, see how he's reading this one as Khan looks to unload to the body.
You know, I really believe in this round, Khan's saying to himself, let me see if I can stop this kid. Let me see if I can really set down on my punches and plant my feet, see if I can hurt him. Hasn't hurt him all night long yet, John.
No, he's not. There's no. Although he's landed flush two or three times, and made some really good, solid-looking uppercuts, he's not wobbled, Drilzane. Remember, the man who's been down was Khan. OK, he was off balance, but nevertheless went down for the first time in his pro career.
Down, applying the pressure, but not doing enough of it, not punching off it.
Kind of leap in behind that left-hand lead. Khan, remember, only in his 10th professional fight.
This Drilzane, facially, John, resembles Miguel Cotto, the new WBA.
Yeah, he does a bit, doesn't he?
The new WBA light-welterweight champion.
He does a little. Fortunately, doesn't punch quite like Miguel Cotto. Well, there goes the bell to end the ninth round. Khan in control, but he is learning a few lessons out there, I think. Here's Barry McGuigan. How do you see it, Barry?
I agree. I think he is learning a few lessons. He's boxed exceptionally well, despite that dubious knockdown in the seventh, which I question. I don't think he was knocked down at all, actually. But it won't do him any harm, the fact that he got knocked down, dented his pride a little bit. But he's handled it very well. He's never boxed 10 rounds before. He's handled it in a genuine late one to win. And sure, he's not able to bowl this guy over. But the point is, he's placing every punch and he's boxing beautifully, mixing his combinations of head and body. Yes, I agree. I'd like to see his hands held a bit higher. But he's learning, and he hasn't taken too many bumps, and very good display. Good fun.
Thanks a lot, Barry. Well, Amir Khan then has one round to go on his way, it looks, towards this intercontinental belt, as recognised by the IBF, and a big, big crowd has hung on to see the conclusion. Late here, terrific evening's entertainment of boxing. And Amir Khan now, is he 3 minutes away from his first professional belt?
Well, I think he is, John. No, barring the knockout, which is what Drilzane needs and knows.
He's caught him with the right hand. And Khan wants to hold on.
Well, it's the only way he can win this fight now, John. It's the KO Khan.
Drilzane didn't like the fact that the referee stepped between them then. He caught Khan with the right hand in that corner. Khan looks to have regrouped well. And the initial flurry of Drilzane maybe has blown itself out. Goes to the cards, remember, if it does go the distance. John Coyle, Roy Francis and Terry O'Connor are the referees, are the judges rather. All of them top-class referees. Roy Francis now retired.
But for me, John, this has been a real good learning curve for Amir Khan. I do think he stepped up to the plate. It's his first 10-round fight.
Caught again by that right-hand counter. Drilzane trying to stalk the British fighter down. calm faithful have been a little bit quiet, but now they roar as he uncorks that lovely left uppercut. Good fast hands, good hand speed. Looks as though now it's going to go the distance.
I would have liked to have seen more head movement from Khan, though, John. And more feints, John. More kick.
Oh! Got caught again, flush. Good right hand by Drilzane. Khan now looks as though he means business. Going to try and produce the grandstand finish. But it was the right hand from Drilzane, which again rocked back the head of Khan.
Needs to move the head.
Well, it was right on cue, just when you were saying, I'd like to see more head movement. Good shot again from Khan, and he's finishing the fight fast. Gets caught again by a left hand, but Khan's looking to take him out in the closing seconds of the 10th round. Gets caught again by a right hand counter. He was wide open, and as he punched himself out there, he couldn't sustain it, and he was caught by a really sweet right hand back from Drilzane.
Well, Drilzane's just left it much too late.
Khan couldn't get him out, believe me, he was trying to finish that fight there. Beckoning Drilzane in, and he's been forced to go the distance. Khan's won the fight, no question about it. He's won it by a long way, but Drilzane has made him go through the gears and has tested him all the way. Amir Khan has still got the L plates on, he's got the first belt, but Drilzane, my word, he showed some guts when Khan started to unload. Came in with a solid right hand there, Duke.
It was a good shot on Khan. Wanted to hold on, John.
Whoosh.
Look, he has to hold on.
And here's Amir unloading. Left hand from Drilzane as Khan does so. Maybe a little bit wild with that attack. And takes one or two shots in reply. And in the end, virtually punched himself to a standstill.
Yeah, he gave it his all, John.
Amir thinks he's done it, and I don't think there can be any doubt that he's won the fight. But it was a good scrap, a proper fight.
Absolutely.
Cards are being tallied, and words of congratulation for Amir Khan from Father Shah and manager Asif Vali. And there's Rachid Drilzane, who's certainly given a good account of himself. Jamie Moore there in the corner, congratulating his training partner. And we wait now to see what the scorecards are. We've just got him losing the one round, the seventh. Two.
Absolutely, John. It was an invaluable experience for Amir Khan. I can't see that he's lost this at all. Nice learning curve.
And in a moment or so, I think we're going to have the final scorecards. So taking a long time just checking everything's absolutely right. The belt's been brought into the ring. What a good night's entertainment we've had. If you're just joining us, well, where were you? Where were you? At last, Audley Harrison did what he's been threatening to do and talking about doing for the last 6 years. He looked like a world-class fighter as he beat Danny Williams. And now Amir Khan, a bit of icing on the cake, waves to his fans there on the far side of the big auditorium here in London. And still we wait for Michael Pass, the master of ceremonies, and I think now we can get the result of this IBF Intercontinental Light Welterweight Championship fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 10 pulsating rounds of championship boxing, we have a unanimous decision. All three judges, John Coyle, Roy Francis and Terry O'Connor, are all in full agreement to the score of 99-91 for the winner and the new IBF Intercontinental Light Welterweight Champion from Malta.
Won all bar one round, that'll be the seventh, and it was scored by the judges, as you probably heard, only a 10-9 round, not a 10-8. So Khan gets his belt, and the I'll tell you what, Duke, I think he's learnt more tonight than he has in the rest of his career.
Yeah.